Yeah, not even you.
Scene opens with a soft pan over Squidward's domain. SpongeBob and Patrick waddle with intent to enter. With the nifty skills acquired via undisclosed pretense, they break into his humble abode. Well, Patrick, it appears as though we've gotten into a real pickle.
I agree, SpongeBob. If we are in a pickle, I guess you would be my jar filled with stale, moist juices.
Everything I've tried, everything I want, I fail. What meaning can life have if nothing can bring me joy?
This newfound life of crime has given me a rush. My minimum wage job has grown tiresome, and I seek a new adventure. While this has started as a simple trespassing upon our neighborly squid's sacred castle, I find myself with the innate desire to do more.
I hear you, my sponge boy. I've never felt so vital, viscous, so hardened, so treasured. I've had an eye on several potential stocks of which I share insider information.
We need a patsy, Pat.
Why don't we gain the acquaintance of our new housemate, our squid in arms, so to speak?
I can't go on anymore. I have no friends, no career. My God fucking why must you do this to me?
But Pat, monetary gains are vapid, limited in nature. I have needs. Violent needs.
You talk of murder?
I want to spill blood, to enter another body with my rusted blade, to slice the vital organs of my brethren and see them enter the abyss of death.
I try to be nice to people, play by the rules, but nobody loves me. Nobody wants the soft touch of my lengthy arms.
This sounds nice. The sins of man should be condemned. Nobody is safe from the selfish drive our biology seeks out. Death is a release from this sick, twisted world, SpongeBob. The pain we cause is insignificant in the never-ending tale of human suffering.
Yes, Pat, my trusted ally, but you see, my own desires are selfish as well. I seek out help, but I can't help but fall to self-indulgent lusts. The lusts of another body, the heat that permeates. Love is a lie, but a man still has desires.
The forced entry of supple flesh is taboo in Bikini Bottom, SpongeBob. But the stimulation of our biological drive, the attempt to procreate, is not limited by man's law. We need to act, SpongeBob, before they act upon us. Social Darwinism, SpongeBob. The strong will survive.
If I left this cruel world, who would care? Who would ponder my struggles? Would they mourn? Or would they try and forget, for they attempt to avoid the great question? What drives us to destroy our greatest gift?
But Pat, sexual pleasures are temporary. They fade without long-standing gains. Such gains we will need if we are to elongate our sinful splendor.
I agree, SpongeBob. What we speak of will last but hours. Moments of joy that fade into the void. We need change. Or more specifically, we need them to change.
You speak of treason, anarchism, and a world of structure. For we live in a simulation, a game, constructed by those on top. Let us end the hierarchy, the sickly organization that claims control of our lives.
The pain of life is temporary, but I can't say even my legacy will prevail. A fine threaded rope, a Victorian chair, stained with the memory of so many nights eating my dinner alone. It's poetic. My pathetic life ended with such pathetic household goods.
At this moment, Squidward assumes the position.
My life was fine, but death is good.
At that moment, Squidward's neck snaps as his corpse dangles in the shadows. Patrick, our friend has died. His life ended at his own hand. His body lingers, motionless. But his meat is not useless. His blood may no longer flow, but his juices can offer us some use.
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
In his life, Squidward brought no pleasure to others, nor himself. But in his death, his body can. We will pleasure his limp, tangy skin, and in turn, we will gain our own pleasure.
You must be kidding. To soil our friend's body?
Think of it, Patrick. We got ourselves in a real pickle today. And now Squidward will have a pickle inside him.